Hey, welcome back, folks. You guys already know, Terencio Freeman here, Crypto Don Fepe. Great to have you back with me. Of course, to this being a continuation to where I left off with the previous video. And if you happen to be here on my channel for the first time, great to have you. Okay, make sure that you do subscribe, all right? Bang that subscribers button. And also make sure you bang that bell, okay? That way you get notified. YouTube and its shenanigans, not sending out notifications to the subscribers. It's important that you guys bang the get notifications bell so that way you guys stay updated and when I upload a YouTube video and when I go live as well. Okay, and I do appreciate you guys doing that. And of course, if you've been enjoying the content within my channel, and of course, this video that I'm going to share with you in a few minutes, definitely go ahead and smash the thumbs up. It'll definitely help build up my channel. As you guys know, I can't do it without my fellow crypto YouTubers, crypto stars, rock stars, all of you guys, okay? And can't build it without you guys, okay? And of course, leave me some comments. Comments definitely help as well. And let me know, if there's something you don't like about my videos, hey, I'm good with taking, criticism, so it's okay, I'm open to that, it can definitely help. But anyway, let's get into this mining town that I wanted to share with you. And also we're gonna get into the I don't know, there's a Bitcoin SV and Bitcoin Cash halvings. Could it, spell doom for the miners? I mean, mining right now, I think, in my opinion, is still profitable. I mean, I think, with the all-time high of the hash rate and it's like the miners are back at it. You know what I mean? And again, I'm no crypto guru, but I go by what I observe, and I do listen to a lot of other crypto influencers, especially in the blockchain arena. And of course, with mining, of course, blockchain is always in the conversation as well. I mean, it goes hand in hand. So anyway, we're gonna get into this and see what's going on with this town. But before we do, make sure that you do give yourselves the opportunity by checking the links down below. And that way you can find a way to earn Bitcoin passively as well. Okay, there'll be links down below for you guys to do, to go check out. And as well, if you are interested in tapping into OPM, other people's money, to help build your crypto portfolio as well as your wealth, go right ahead. Make sure that you leave me your email or reach out to me in any of my social media links down below, and you can find me that way as well. Or you can email me at bitcointfree@cryptex.com. That's cryptex.com, excuse me. Okay, bitcointfree@cryptex.com. All right, and if you're interested in earning up to 70% in commissions paid out in Bitcoin, then definitely let's get in touch so that way I can send you out those details. So now we have here Northern Bitcoin AG, a Frankfurt-based technology company that's focused on Bitcoin and the production of highly efficient mobile containers. The mobile containers, I've seen that maybe 2 years ago as well. There's a company, they did an ICO where they had these mobile containers mining, storing these mining equipments, you know what I mean? So these are highly efficient mobile containers, and Whitestone US, a service provider for large stationary data centers, are now operating as Northern Data AG following their merger in December. The new company is building a leading global infrastructure for high performance computing, HPC in parentheses, and is home to a Bitcoin mining hotspot, Rockdale, Texas. Wow, so a small town in Texas with 6,000 residents houses world's largest Bitcoin mine. That is interesting. And this is bullish. You know, this is some bullish news in regards to Bitcoin, I would dare say. Because again, the miners are highly making moves. It's like they're mining more than I would dare say a year ago, if give or take, right? But Rockdale, Texas. So with its 100 acre Bitcoin mining operation located in Rockdale. Any of you guys in Texas that are watching this video or pop right in, let me know what you guys think about this as well, man. I mean, all you guys, but anybody from Texas or near Rockdale, Texas, or in Rockdale, I would definitely love to hear from you guys. So this small town of 6,000 residents, Northern Data leases its high-powered facility to companies interested in mining Bitcoin. Sources tell Bloomberg that the SBI Crypto, a unit of SBI Holdings, and Japanese internet giant GMO, the Japanese baby, which started allowing employees to earn part of their salaries in Bitcoin back in 2017, will launch its crypto mining operation at Northern Data's Rockdale location through a large leasing contract designed to bring, in quote, further large crypto savvy investors on board, close quote. I mean, this place got to be huge too. The data center will have an initial capacity of 300 megawatts, scaling up to a full gigawatt of computing power by the end of the year, a target that would establish Northern Data as the world's largest Bitcoin mining operation, providing three times the capacity of neighboring Bitmain, which launched its Rockdale mining farm in October of 2019. Ah, interesting. I did not know that. Whitestone US co-founder Lyle I'm butchering your name, so Lyle, we'll just keep it that way. Founder Lyle says demand has been overwhelming and that the new Texas facility is a game changer in the industry. What do you guys think, man? Let me know down below. It says also that Bitcoin miners continue to flock to Texas for its cheap electricity in order to solve complex mathematical puzzles that produce new Bitcoins. I'm telling you, this is great news for BTC. And Bloomberg says here, Bloomberg analysis, Mike McGlone, in quotes, says Bitcoin is attracting more institutional investors, and with the notion of limited supply and mass adoption, Bitcoin is winning the race. Close quote. That's a fact. Bitcoin is winning the race. That is a fact. And I do like this right here. So let me know what you guys think down below. Yay or nay? I'm sure the majority of you guys are with the yay. I mean, you know, this is good for the small town. Of course, that's jobs. And, you know, for it to be housing the world's largest, you know, as being reported here, the world's largest Bitcoin mine is just huge. This is great news for Bitcoin, you know, and for us Bitcoin investors, hodlers, you know. I think this is awesome. But let's get into what's going on with this Bitcoin SV and Bitcoin Cash halvings spelled doom for the miners. So mining is supposed to be a lucrative activity, right? Earning cryptocurrency by running specialist machines continuously. But for Bitcoin SV, Bitcoin Satoshi Vision, and Bitcoin Cash, this simple process is providing to be far more profitable. Oh, to be far from profitable. Excuse me. It says miners absorb low fees, non-lucrative block rewards. So miners for the two blockchains which split off from Bitcoin in a rather continuous manner are working altruistically to support the chain. Additionally, both chains boast of much cheaper transactions, meaning very low additional fees for miners. So here we have a tweet from Ceteris Paribus. He says Bitcoin Cash and Bitcoin Satoshi Vision miners have made 300 or less of the combined fees over the past 24 hours after their halvings. New issuance will be cut from a combined 600K to 300K. Miners are already rationally mining these chains at a loss. Both halvings will occur before BTC. Interesting, guys. So the transaction fees are viewed as a minor addition, with most chains having rather negligible fees levels. The chief reward for miners comes from the coins sent for solving a block. Even for Bitcoin's chain, fees hover around 200,000 per day, a fraction of the block reward. 200,000 per day. But the results are even worse for BSV and BCH. What is more, the miners on these networks need to supply highly specialized, high capacity hardware. The reason is that the chains attempt to distribute larger blocks, putting additional strain on miners and node operators. Well, I didn't even know that. I mean, these are forks out of BTC, so. And you notice some other forks tend to do well when BTC does well, like Bitcoin Diamond was just doing well. Bitcoin Gold pumped up a little bit as well, right? These Bitcoin forked coins remained depressed. That's interesting. So, in addition to absorbing hardware costs, the networks are also not lucrative enough, with miners working below break even. That'll piss anybody off too. Additionally, BSV miners are pressured to hold on to the block rewards as selling would further depress the asset's price. BSV mining has also seen altruistic involvement in the past, block production on multiple occasions ever since the August 2017 hard fork, has depended on an unknown miner. The miner is suspected to be Bitmain. No, what do you guys think, man? What do you guys think about BCH and the BSV miners? Very interesting, though. But yeah, let me know what you guys think down below. Of course, I wanted to finish up and continue on from the previous video. Check out the video up above. You see the card. And of course, you guys be blessed, and I'll see you guys in the next video. All right, don't forget, check out the links down below. Subscribe, bang the get notifications bell, and please do smash the likes, guys. Many blessings to each and every one of you guys. Thank you.